Hello students, let us discuss the one matrix matching from the elimination reactions concept. Okay, so here it is a first reaction. In a first reaction, what is the actual product? So here in this case, see this one. So here in this elimination reaction, this is the methyl methyl, no hydrogen, this bromine above the plane, and here hydrogen, deuterium. So this hydrogen above the plane and deuterium below the plane. Actually it is a E2 elimination reaction. Okay, in E2 elimination reaction, the groups which are trans each other are eliminated. So bromine and deuterium are eliminated in this reaction. So the product is this one. So it is a stereospecific reaction. Why it is a stereospecific? It's isomer. It's isomer for suppose below the plane bromine, above the plane hydrogen, below the plane deuterium. Here Br hydrogen, those two are removed. Deuterium remains same. So it is stereospecific reaction because the product formation depends on the stereochemistry of the product. Sorry, stereochemistry of the reactant. Okay, different stereoisomer gives a different product. So it is specific for a specific stereoisomer. Product formation is a specific for the specific reacted. So it is a stereospecific reaction. Okay, that's it. So here in this case, and it is a only one product. Actually here in this case only one product is possible, that is the Hofmann product as well as a Seidel product. We cannot say it is Hofmann product, it is a Seidel product. If there are the possibility of the two products, we can say the elimination Hofmann product and the Seidel product. So in this case, this reaction is also not resoselective because one structural isomer is only possible. Okay, only one structural isomer is only possible because at this carbon only hydrogen is there, at this carbon hydrogen is not there. If there is a hydrogen at this one, we will get these products. Okay, for suppose only one methyl, this is hydrogen and deuterium. Okay, or like this here methyl, hydrogen or something deuterium. So these, if these two are formed, then these two are the that means it is a Seidel product, it is a Hofmann product, and it is a resoselective also. Resoselective means here among the possible structural isomer, one structural isomer is major, that is a resoselective. One structural isomer is major, that is resoselective. Okay, here only one alkene is possible, that's it. So it is not a resoselective. If two alkenes are possible, one is a major, so that is a resoselective. That's it. So it is not a resoselective, it's not a Hofmann elimination, it's not a Seidel of elimination, because only one product is formed in this reaction. Okay, and the stereospecific anti elimination reaction, because this stereoisomer produces one product, this stereoisomer produces one product. It is a stereospecific anti-elimination reaction. Only option yes for this one. Okay, and the formation of the conjugate base is not involved in this reaction. Okay, because it is a E2 elimination reaction, it is a single step process. So next here, this methyl hydrogen chlorine hydrogen hydrogen, you can see this question. So in this case, write the stereoisomer like here. In this case, chlorine downward, CH3 and H. This one hydrogen, here hydrogen, downward pH. Okay. So in this case, this chlorine and hydrogen, these two are exactly opposite, trans each other. So elimination takes place, double bond hydrogen. This hydrogen, this is phenyl actually. Okay. Because this carbon converted into sp2 carbon, so here some bonds are turned out. So here in this case, trans isomer is a major product. Trans isomer is a major product. Okay, so next here another possibility, chlorine, here alpha carbon, it is a beta carbon. From this beta carbon hydrogen is removed, or from this carbon hydrogen is removed. So in that case, another possibility product CH2 double bond, here hydrogen bond, here hydrogen, hydrogen pH, it is also one of the possible product in this reaction. Okay, that's it. That means here between two structurally different alkenes, one structural alkene is a major product. Okay, that has a conjugation stability, more substituted, it is more stable, it is less stable. So one structural isomer is major. So this reaction is a stereoselective reaction. Okay, it is a stereoselective reaction. So that means it is a P actually. Next, here in this case, what is the major product? Seijal product is a major, so R, and it is not a stereospecific reaction because this carbon is not a chiral carbon. Okay, so any isomer can give the same major product. Okay, that's it. Of course, your conjugate base is not formed. Okay, no? So here finally B selected for the P and R options. Next, you see this one. So here in this case, this hydrogen CN, here fluorine is a bad leaving group. CN is electron withdrawing group. So these are the suitable conditions to for the unimolecular conjugate base elimination reaction. So pH minus, okay, pH minus, remove the H plus first of all. So H, C minus, this one CN, CH, CHME2 actually. Okay, here hydrogen, here fluorine is removed. Okay, here fluorine is removed. So as a result, HC, CN double bond, CH, CHME2. That is a major product. And one more possibility. This pH minus, remove the hydrogen from this carbon also, and remove the fluorine. So in this case, H2 here, CN, CH double bond C, methyl and this methyl. It is also one of the possible products. It is also one of the possible products. Between these two possible alkenes, structurally different alkenes, one is a major, this one is a major, because this hydrogen is a more acidic one, this is removed. Okay, so in this case, actually first after removal of the proton, your conjugate base is formed. So this elimination takes place through the conjugate base. That's why it is a conjugate base elimination reaction. Okay, so it is a rhizoselective reaction P. And between these two, which is a major product? This is the major product. Okay, this is the major product. So here in this case, it is a more substituted alkene, it is a less substituted alkene. So it is the Hoffmann product, it is a Seijal product. So here the Hoffmann product is major, so PQ. And next, this one has no stereochemistry actually, because it's not a chiral carbon, it's not a chiral carbon. Okay, so here in this case, option C cannot get the S stereospecific anti-elimination. It is not an anti-elimination reaction actually. Okay, so stereospecific anti-elimination is not there. So here that involves formation of the conjugate base PQT actually. Okay, PQT, that's it. Okay, so here also tuple. It is a conjugate. Here this product is formed through the E1-CB mechanism. Of course, you can say this product is formed by the E2 elimination direct. Okay, because here in this case, conjugate base is not much stable. Here conjugate base, if proton is removed, here we will get the stable anion. So this here removal of this proton and then leaving of the fluorine, it involves two steps actually. Okay, but here formation of the formation of the alkene is a rated determining step in a E1-CB reactions. Okay, that's it. Next here, MeO minus here, the base actually that favors the E2 reaction. So Cl, hydrogen, these two are opposite exactly. So the product is this one. And here for this chlorine, this hydrogen also opposite. So in this case, we can get this product also. It is a less substituted alkene, it is a more substituted alkene, it is Seijal product, it is Hoffmann product, but your Seijal product is major. So this one getting a R option, and here T radioselective also. Between these two possible structural isomer, one structural isomer is major, so it is a radioselective PR, and next it is a stereospecific also. It's another isomer like this one, the hydrogen chlorine. This is methyl hydrogen trans isomer. Here hydrogen hydrogen same side, cis isomer. Hydrogen hydrogen opposite side, it is a trans isomer. So here in this case, for this reactant, the major product is this one, CH3, like this. The major product is this one, because here chlorine, and here from this one hydrogen is removed. Here from this carbon hydrogen cannot be removed, because that hydrogen is not in a cis, is not in a anti position. That hydrogen is in a cis position, so this hydrogen cannot be removed. But from the adjacent carbon, one hydrogen cis and one hydrogen trans in position, so that hydrogen can be removed from this carbon. So as a result, we got this product as a major product. So this stereoisomer produce this one as a major product, this stereoisomer produce this one as a major product. So it is a stereospecific anti-elimination reaction. So PRS, that's it. Okay, I think it is a very good matrix matching type question, so especially from the elimination reactions. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe my channel, like the video and share the video.